Let's get you more. That's ABC7's promise every night. So the officer's duty is to report child neglect, and his own department is saying he didn't.
But that begs the question, did he not get training on how to deal with it? ABC7's Rachel Anderson talked to experts about it.
They say that training needs to be a priority. At a time when some are calling to defund the police, local law enforcement experts and FGCU professors say no, reallocate the money within the agency, don't give it away.
And when a budget is cut, the first thing to be cut is training.
FGCU professor Dr. David Thomas has been in law enforcement for 42 years. He says defunding is the last thing that should happen for police reform.
Every time there's a new issue, do we defund that, defund policing to handle that issue?
Most of the people calling to defund the police aren't saying get rid of the police. They're saying move more money from enforcement and give it to social services, education, or health care. But FGCU Professor of Justice Studies Pamela C. says doing that would defeat the purpose of attempting reform.
Defunding them takes away the ability for additional training and experience.
Both experts say it begins with communication between police and citizens.
You must know your own community in order to understand what you are going to have to respond to.
No two places are alike, so no two agencies should expect to respond the same.
It is incumbent upon each community to sit down with this police department and have that discussion to tell them what they want and how they want their officers to act and proceed.
They need to be able to know how to call, when to call, and what resources are available.
Resources like child abuse experts, mental health professionals, and others. Something that right now tends to fall into the hands of police.
Police don't have any special training to deal with mental health issues. But when I started, look, you're going to have to go make the assessment. Law enforcement's there 24 hours a day. They've made it, it's easier to kind of just dump these things on them.
They say education, communication, and training will spark change, but it won't happen overnight, and it will take each individual agency to make a difference within. In Fort Myers, Rachel Anderson, ABC 7.